Happy Friday, everybody! Yay! Barbecue Friday! It's going to be a good Friday. We're going to have some tasty food. We're going to do some fun stuff. And we're going to have a great morning routine here for you. Starting with some headlines. Which is, he's back! Keanu Reeves, John Wick, returns in the Ana de Armas action spin-off, Ballerina. Yeah, that was a mouthful of a headline, and Keanu Reeves is apparently going to make a cameo in it. When they say this stuff, it's like, get y'all hyped up, and then it's like a flashback, and it's just a small scene with them. It's a scene from one of the movies he already did. It's not an actual new John Wick experience, so, we'll see. We'll probably watch it. It'll be good. If it's in the John Wick world, it'll probably be pretty good. All right, next up. Captain America, Brave New World. CinemaCon footage shows Anthony Mackie saving Harrison Ford from White House assassination. Harrison Ford is the president again? That's awesome. What hasn't this guy done? He's been Han Solo. He's Indiana Jones. He has been the president now twice, apparently. I mean, this guy is just amazing, really. So, all the Captain America stuff, I'm just excited about the part that Harrison Ford is the President of the United States again. Air Force One, if you want to see him the President the first time, you'll root for him. You'll vote for him. Yes. All right, next up. This one's got me a little on edge. I'm a little concerned right here. Popeye the Sailor Man, teaser trailer with Conor McGregor.
There emerges a man of unyielding strength, unshakable resolve, and indomitable spirit.
That's all right, Olive. I'll save ya.
With every challenge he faces, every obstacle he overcomes, he will prove that true strength lies not in muscle, but in heart.
I'm not just any sailor. I'm the toughest one on the seven seas.
A tale of courage, resilience, and the enduring power of the human spirit.
Okay, if you don't know who Popeye the Sailor Man is, in the late 70s, early 80s, there was a cartoon about Popeye the Sailor Man based off of a U.S. war sailor, or, you know, sailor in the Navy, who had these huge, massive forearms that were ridiculous in size. He was a very scrawny guy otherwise. And when the bully came along to beat him up, Popeye would get beat up, but then he'd eat a raw can of spinach, and all of a sudden he'd get super strong and beat up the bully, Brutus, right? So, years later in the 80s, they made a Popeye movie with a very little known Robin Williams at the time as Popeye. It also had some other characters in it that we might know today. I'm totally blanking on the other lady's name that was in it. But this was a really, really weird movie that I think was produced by Steven Spielberg. It might have been directed by him as well. Don Bluth, I think, maybe. But, weird movie, done well, interesting, very comical, close to the cartoon. But this is Conor McGregor. This is a new-aged Popeye. I'm not sure how this is going to work out. So we'll see what happens. I'm not sure what to think about this. And Conor McGregor, when he was in the, what the heck was the name of the movie, Roadhouse, he played Conor McGregor. He was Conor McGregor, kind of being Conor McGregor, so we'll see. I don't know. We'll see. He's working on the acting chops. We'll give him a chance here. All right. It is Friday, so we've got to talk about movies, and I got two here. One was highly recommended by Alana, but not well. She knows so much about this movie.
She sold it really well.
Yeah, we're all excited to go, and then I looked it up, and it's like, man, she just knows what's going on, because according to the website, there are no plot details available about this movie. She knows something's going on.
There's something going on.
There's a movie. There's something happening.
Carl Iron has a beginning, middle, and end.
Ooh, a beginning and a middle.
Yeah,
and
it has a movie title.
That's and the title. That's
maybe
awesome.
A twist.
This is gonna be. This is gonna be good. So this is Abigail coming out in the movie theaters today. Apparently it has to do with vampires, but Alana wasn't really sure. She was kind of vague on the details, so we'll see. But that's out for you if you're into that kind of thing. And next up we have, this one actually should be pretty good. It's The Ministry of Ungentlemanly Warfare. This was directed by Guy Ritchie. Guy Ritchie's movies are always a little weird, but very good. Very stylistic, always great casts, lots going on, but if nothing else, you can go check out one of those movies if you're brave enough to check out Alana's recommendation, Abigail. Get that popcorn, buy that soda, support those movie theaters, keep them charging ahead, keep the movie industry going, because we love it so much.
I didn't recommend it!
Whoa, she did recommend it, because I specifically said I need to find a movie, and she said, I got one! And Abigail, it's coming out! Oh, because recommending and suggesting are two different things.
They are!
I don't recommend you do this. I just suggest that you do this.
I was just trying to be helpful.
Oh, yeah. See what happens when you're trying to be helpful? People run right over you. All right. Because we're on the movie cake and it's Fridays, we got to talk to Clayton and what he's got going with the Marvel Universe. Now, again, I don't know who's out there that's really in the Marvel Universe, but somebody needs to get a wrangle in on this guy because he's talking about good movies and I know he's missing some of the details. So any of you that know he's missing the details, you need to be sitting right over here and catching him on those details. Saying, hold on, buddy. I know you think that that's a cool part of the story, but this is actually this is that. Someone needs to school him a little bit, and I know you're out there. You need to be sitting over here when he's talking Marvel stuff, right? However many eyes you got going. I got four. You got however many. Let's get some eyeballs on that Clayton guy.
It's Friday again, so you know what time that is, right? It's party time! Party all the time. Eddie Murphy, great singer. Can't say that with a straight face. But hey, alright, so it is time to talk about the weekly Marvel movie. And we're going to talk about one that gets a lot of hate, but I actually kind of like. It is Ghost Rider.
Johnny Blaze, no one has ever attempted such a distance before. 300 feet from field goal to field goal. What's going through your mind right now?
You look really good. I got lucky.
Luck don't cover it, JP. You got an angel looking after you.
Maybe it's something else. All you have to do is sigh.
Ghost Rider. It's the story of Johnny Blaze, okay? Played by Nicolas Cage, who I actually like a lot. Nicolas Cage, he's turned into a kind of a weirdo actor lately, but he does his thing, and I do like his movies, but he's famous for a lot of movies, Raising Arizona, Con Air, The Rock, all kinds of great movies, but Ghost Rider. At first, when he was cast as the character of Johnny Blaze, who is a stuntman, he rides a motorcycle, he's a stuntman, he does all these crazy stunts. I was a little bit unsure if he would be that good for that role as Johnny Blaze. But I actually did like it. So this is the story of he's a stuntman and his father is dying of cancer, is dying, and he sells his soul to the devil. And he does it out of love, you know, and he becomes like an emissary for, it's not even the devil, it's Mephistos, is the character from Marvel, a very powerful character, played by Peter Fonda. They did kind of make him a little weak in the movie because he is one of the most powerful characters in all of the Marvel comics. So I highly recommend that you guys see this movie. It is a fun movie. Ghost Rider is a cool character. Check out his comic books. I've mentioned him before in some of the previous things. So when we talked about Fantastic Four in the comics, he became part of the new Fantastic Four with Spider-Man, the Hulk, Wolverine, and Ghost Rider, which is really cool. But he's a pretty cool in-depth character. They're talking about remaking him, and there is rumor that he may show up in the new Deadpool movie. Deadpool movie is going to have a lot of characters from a lot of different universes, and if we can see Nicolas Cage as Ghost Rider again, I will think that's really awesome. So highly recommend it. It's from 2007. It's actually a pretty well done movie for back then. Nothing special. It's not super long, but it is an enjoyable ride. It's an enjoyable ride. Thank you. We'll talk to you guys again next week for another edition of Marvel Friday.
So here's Gary with some free Epic Games.
They're free! They're free.
Hey everybody, happy Friday. Guys, at the Epic Games Store, this week we have two games. Only one of which I'm familiar with. The other one is this one. This one's called The Big Con. I mean, it was Ali. Your mom owns a video store, right? The evil landlord is trying to take your mama's video store. So you have to go cross country, on a cross country road trip to get enough money to save your mama's video store. That's called the Big Con because you have to con your way across 1990s United States. 1990s United States. You do so by wearing disguises, by grifting people, which is tricking people out of their money, by picking their pockets, by whatever means necessary to get their money. Now I know it sounds like you're being a real juvenile delinquent. Since you're a teenager, I'm gonna guess below 18. But what you're doing is you're picking and choosing who you con. You can't con everybody. Some require more disguises than others, but you find what works, and you con them out of their money, and you get enough money to save your mother's 1990s video store. Anyone knows about video stores in the 90s, apparently those were a big deal. So check it out. That one is free. That was the first free one. It's called The Big Con. And it's free until the 26th. Also, the second game, the second free game at the Epic Game Store is one that I have a little bit more familiarity of. It is called, wait for it, Town of Salem 2. Town of Salem 2. Now, if anyone here has heard of Town of Salem 1, this is like it, only a little bit more graphically intense. Town of Salem is a game, it's one of those games where something happens and someone in the town did it, only they know who did it. Only they know who they are. And it's their job to convince everybody else in the town that they're not the one that did it, or that someone else specific did it. Now, if you pull that off and that person gets the punishment for it, then you've won. If they figure out that you're the person who's guilty, then they won. Right? There's a few games out there like that. This, in my opinion, is one of the older ones. Well, Town of Salem 1 was one of the older ones. This one, let's see, when did this one come out? When did this one come out? Did it just come out, or? Let's see, 2023, August of 2023, so yeah, not that long ago. But it's the same idea. Same idea of more cartoony graphics. So, Town of Salem 2 is the second free game at the Epic Game Store this week until next Thursday, early in the morning. So get them now, get them while you can.
They're free. They're free!
See, I think that... Now what was Gary doing there? Was he suggesting or he was recommending? I don't know what to do now, I'm confused. If someone suggests something to me, should I deny it? Or does it have to be a recommendation for me to actually do it? I'm so confused now. gosh. We're just going to have to go on with the question of the day because I need to think about something else. So question of the day right here.
Would you rather have a ketchup on ice cream or sugar on pizza?
Sugar on pizza. Yes.
Like I said, I would choose sugar on pizza.
I can't believe it. So now I'm confused about, is it a suggestion or a request or a recommendation? Sugar on ice cream on pizza, pizza on sugar. My Friday is going south very quick. Ice cream, ketchup on ice cream. That's a no brainer. That's just not happening. That's really, well, maybe the flavor of ice cream matters. It didn't stipulate it's vanilla. I'm thinking of vanilla, I'm thinking of chocolate. Maybe there's a flavor where ketchup actually works. I don't know. But sugar on pizza, just a dusting might be worth it. I'm looking at a pile, you know? So I guess I can figure this out much better than a recommendation or a suggestion from Alana. All right, next up. Did you know? If it has anything to do with recommendations or suggestions, I'm just going to skip right by it. Here we go, Zach.
Did you know that dragonflies have 6 legs, but they can't walk? They're only able to perch, and they can't use their legs at all.
Dragonflies have 6 legs but can't walk. So those aren't legs, that's landing gear. That's all that is, it's landing gear. They don't have, if they can't walk, they're not legs. It's just landing gear, right? So it's the spaceships and just the legs, you know, it's landing gear, that's it. That's what it should be called. Don't call them legs. Dragonflies don't have legs, they have landing gear. That's it. Very good. No, that's interesting. That's cool. I'm never going to stop thinking about that or calling their legs landing gear. Absolutely. All right, blooper time. Sadly, we don't have video of Alana requesting or suggesting. So we need to analyze that and really understand. Was it a request or a suggestion or a recommendation? Now I'm really confused because she didn't request me to do it. She recommended that I do it. Or she suggested. Anyway, here's the bloopers for the week.
Hoist the stairs and swallow those poop dicks! Damn it! Alright, mateys! Alright, mateys! Hoist the sails! And swallow those poop dicks! And swallow those poop men!
Still got chips on me.
Rolling,
now. Okay.
Make sure you wipe all the chips off.
I cannot guarantee that.
Okay. Happy Friday.
Let's start again.
Happy.
Was
Friday.
That Steve?
Hey, yeah.
Oh, that's the lady in the tower.
What's the question?
What's the answer?
Okay, here we go.
Where are you going, right?
Oh, where's that from?
All right, we are having fun doing all this and having a blast, having you guys in here, being a part of all this. Lots more good stuff to come. We still have this thing off the side that we've got to get to. We're working on it, we're working really hard at getting there. It's tough these days, but we're getting there. All right, have a great Friday. We're going to have some tasty food in a little bit, and we're going to do some fun stuff. And then we're off to the great weekend. It is the weekend that we celebrate the Earth Day on the 20th. Which is tomorrow, Saturday. There's got to be some like Earth Day celebrations or something going on. Check that stuff out. Think about the Earth, but you should do it every day. Have a great Friday, everybody. Take care.